Okay, you've agreed to play in this exclusive match. How much are you looking forward to it?
I'm looking forward to it. I haven't played a lot, to be honest, since I retired. I played the odd game on the beach, a bit in the garden with my kids. I played once in Barbados and got rolled over there cheaply. So I am looking forward. I've not played 2020 cricket, so it'll be a good day. Goughy's on the opposition. There'll be a few ex-England players, a few players from around the world. So it'll be a good fun. It's a great ground as well, Wormsley. So I'm looking forward to it, but the body might ache the next day. I don't even think I've got any whites or coloured gear or cricket equipment anywhere, so that might have to be a phone call to Gray Nichols first to get some gear.
And a great opportunity for cricket fans to come and join you, obviously, in this game.
Absolutely. I mean, usually these days are all about 11 pros against 11 pros, so this is an unusual setup, really, that if you do get the opportunity of getting these tickets and coming along, then you end up playing with the likes of myself and Goughy, three professional cricketers on either side. Alex Stewart might be there, Graham Hick. So it'll be about seven or eight amateurs and three professionals. I don't know who'll be better at that stage, but so there'll be a lot of banter as well. It won't be completely serious stuff. There'll be a lot of banter. There'll be a wide range of cricketing ability, and it should be fun. I mean, there'll be a few battles. Gough, from what I've heard in these sort of games, still runs in and tries to bowl 100 miles an hour. Hickey's still a very talented player. Stewart's very fit, and I'm not. So, yeah, I mean, the way to do it is to get some tickets. Bangladesh, Australia, one day, as Pakistan, test matches, and one day. So get on before Christmas, ecb.co.uk/liveitlive. Get some tickets and try and get into the draw to play in these games. There's also a PCA Masters game on after that. So it's a long day. It'll be a social day as well. It won't just be about the cricket. There'll be a fair amount drunk and a lot of chat and a lot of in my day, this is how we used to do it. But if you get the tickets, go online. There's an opportunity for a great day out at Wormsley.
And looking ahead to next summer, how do you see it going?
Well, I mean, I think there's some fantastic sides coming across. You know, if we go to the end one first, you've got Pakistan. I mean, they're an enigmatic side. They can turn up and be anything. They're world champions at most things, Pakistan, in one-day cricket, so they'll be hard to beat in one-day cricket. Test match cricket, a lot of their players have experience of English conditions. They have superb players. You know, you're talking about the likes of Afridi, Umar Gul, Yunis Khan. You know, Mohammad Asif is back in their side. This lad, Saeed Ajmal, spins it both ways. So they've got a lot of talent in their squad, and they're always fun to watch. There's always something happening in the Pakistan series. If you remember the last Pakistan series, there was the Daryl Hare incident. There's always something going on. So get some tickets for those games because they're always fun to watch. Australia one day, as England will want payback after what happened last summer with Australia coming over and walloping them. And England look like they're playing better in one-day cricket in South Africa. So they've and they'll be even more improved by the time Australia comes round, hopefully. And I think Bangladesh are always a joy to watch, to be honest. I think Bangladesh are great fun. They have some really talented. I mean, that lad Ashraful, he is hyper talented, and they're just young lads that play the game the old-fashioned way. Really, they just see ball, hit ball, enjoy it, and they have a lot of fun. Really, they're a bit like Pakistan. They can implode at times, but also, as they showed against Australia in a World Cup, they can also beat anyone on their day.
Atmosphere for Pakistan games in England is always sensational. You know, we showed during the World 2020, you know, fantastic crowd atmosphere. What was it like as an English cricketer playing at home?
Yeah, it's home or away for an England cricketer, you get a lot of support. Win, lose, draw, whatever. In my era, we weren't winning that many, but we still got a lot of support, whether it be from the local crowd or the touring groups or the Barmy Army or whoever. We could not complain about the support we got. You know, Lords, and they were different from ground to ground. Lords was like an amphitheatre. Everyone was on top of you. You could hear the champagne corks being popped. You could hear your mate. It's so close to you now, Lords. You could hear your mate in the stand sort of chirping you, asking you, you know, where are the tickets for? Can we meet up for a beer later? Whereas somewhere like Edgbaston, Headingley, it's a bit more of a football atmosphere. You know, they're well up for it. The beer, it's done. It's worked by midday. The opposition are getting lambasted on the boundary, and it's a much more hostile atmosphere for the opposition. The Oval is somewhere in between, especially now they've built that new stand. That is a little bit more enclosed. So I think every ground has its you know, it's plus points, really. I mean, Trent Bridge is one of the most beautiful places in the world to play, the way they've done up that ground. And all the new grounds as well, Durham. I think it's a special place to go. I always enjoyed playing there. I went to Durham University, so it's always a special place for me. The Rose Bowl, all these places, England. I've never known England get bad support. And you're right, when Pakistan are in town, and Bangladesh, you know, there's a lot of Bangladesh community around in England. There'll be noisy occasions. Don't go expecting a quiet test match. There'll be noisy occasions, especially when Pakistan and Bangladesh are doing well.